Everyone, wow, still so ashy. With a little bit of the fog coming in from the Sonoma fires here in California. Anyhow, I'm Lola, welcome to my channel, and I wanted to do a little video as I was walking to a little babysitting job that I'm heading near the neighborhood. And I wanted to talk about being empathic. And coming from an extroverted person who actually gets more energized when she's surrounded by people. But I also am an empath, so it depends on the mood of people. Someone said it's kind of like just being able to receive the energy, being able to she said receive the energy, download the energy of another person. I will go more as far, I'm pretty sure that's what she meant by what I'm saying, but I'll go as far as like saying to feel the energy, not only to receive it, but you also feel it. Good example is, not gonna lie, I just, before I got ready to come to work, before I was heading to work, I actually cried about what's happening in Sonoma. Like if I had lost my home. One of my kung fu mates said that there's an evacuation in the neighborhood where he grew up, in his childhood home, and it just made me really sad, as if it was me having to be evacuated. For me, that translates as an empath. It's not just being like sympathetic and understanding them, it's actually feeling the feelings that they're feeling. And so, like, I'm going to touch base on the difference between knowing what they're going through and feeling what they're going through. I'm sure that's what she meant, but I just wanted to clarify it for me, for myself, and for others who might have been confused too. Another thing I wanted to touch base is what I do, because I'm an extrovert and I love being around people. But I'm gonna have to admit, as being very empathic, I get overwhelmed at the same time, and the normal thing to do is to retract and reground and re-energize yourselves. Which, in addition, is taking a shower when you get home from the day and from people's energy. Another thing is also cleansing, right? All of these things. Another trick that I do is when I'm going to talk to someone, put a wall, like a window between. You can see each other, but yet their energy is being blocked. Think of it as like their breath can't get to you. And that's one of the tricks that I do. Let me see what else I can do. Carrying your crystals. Well, this one is more for, I haven't been feeling creative, so I've been wanting this, even though it's a aquamarine and it helps connect with water and it helps connect with your emotions, it helps me connect with my creativity. This one happens too. You kind of program it to what you feel it works for you. But anyways, crystals, like for example, did I subconsciously take mine off? This one, I programmed it to help me with protection also. Even though it's not a dark one, or like a hematite or onyx or a obsidian, it still helps with that, because it's a clear quartz. Let me see. Ooh, sorry. I don't know if you can. You see, this is lapis lazuli and blue lace agate. I hope I showed it well. Anyways, that's what I'm needing today. But for the purpose of being empathic, using ones that are like to help chill you, which is hematite, obsidian, onyx, they help with that. So I'm not wearing any of them, but those personally help me, especially when I'm in a situation that will overwhelm me. I'm claustrophobic, and which one is the one about like being scared of like crowds? Is it agoraphobic? No, I don't know. I'm sorry, I'm like really tired. I'm not sure, but also fear of crowds. I tend to get overwhelmed with them. And so the crystals, or even wearing dark colors, help ground you. Let's see. Look here, the tree. Just touching the tree helps before you go where you need to go. Stuff like that have helped me with that. So I want to keep this short. I'm almost where I'm supposed to be. But I hope you have a great day. And sorry, this is a little bit rushed. And I hope it's not too unclear and too unfocused. If not, I'm going to have to redo it. But I hope that this helps.